Alright, g'day everybody. Welcome back to the series. What I have just discovered recently was the bug that was preventing the single player maps from working. And whether or not you actually know about the fact that it's very hard to make a map in single player that actually works. Because most of the time, maybe you're thinking of making a smaller map than what is available on the official, just because you want a little single player world that you can do whatever you want in. So much like the previous episode, you need 1.4 million as the cell size. You don't need to do much more than that. Choose zero, tick UTC if you like. You can give it a name, it doesn't really matter. But in this case, I'm going to do an example of why it fails first, and then what it was that I had to do to fix it. So to show what the problem is, we can basically pick a water tile just to make the map look a little bit nicer. We grab one island. We're going to put smack back in, smack bang in the middle of A1. Set the spawn override to zero. Set it to our home server. And 00 because that's the grid it's on. Now, in theory, if this worked, I should be able to spawn into A1. And I have a 2x2, which has pretty much just one island on it. So, first of all, we're going to save that as my 1x1 example. I will then open it again as the 1x1 example, just so that the game knows exactly, or the editor knows what the name is. We export the file. Done. We then have to go into our projects, edit the file, change it to PNG, as was all described in part one. We then come back into here, we open the PNG version, export all once again. Takes a little bit longer with the PNG than the JPEGs. Done. And then we can have a look in our export folder. In here we have all the images, PNG and JPEG versions. Copy all that across. Boom. Delete the existing files. Rename then, all ready to go, and then we launch Atlas. And this will not work. I will have what looks like a decent grid. It'll be a 4x4, the names will all be there, but it won't actually work. So just to be clear, we just delete all of our saved data, log into single player. Doesn't matter what character I make, we'll just create one. I haven't changed my sounds over here, but anyway, I've spawned into the water, and I can basically fly up and have a look. Well, maybe there's a little bug there that doesn't like you doing it for some reason. Oh, that's right. I don't need to do cheats. I'm at the surface. Fly. Hey, you got it. You got to be just above the water for the fly to work. It's really annoying. But yes, I'm in the middle of the grid, A1, so I've got my 2x2, it's all good. You can see a little bit of blue up here in the corner, but if I was to go to the middle of this A1, the island will not be there. And this is basically showing that it's broken. But I did actually discover a very, very strange fix. And we'll exit out all the way. In the grid editor, what it ends up being, if we load the Maelstrom map, is probably a good example of it. Show the server info, and it's actually down here on B8. If I was to load the Maelstrom map as a map that's usable, you will default to loading into B8 for some reason. It's not even actually ticked as a home server, so it may not even be that one that's actually causing it, but for some reason it needs B8. And so if you load any 11x11 map, the original 15x15, the latest one with all the portals, again, you know, it's big enough that it'll actually accommodate and it will have B8 in there. And for some reason, you need that. So, to fix the problem, I thought to myself, if I'm always spawning into B8, maybe B8 is the critical thing. So I create an 8x8, 1.4 million. I'll probably cut this part out of the video when it comes to it, but that's fine. We end up having the 8x8. What I can actually do is we'll put an island on B8 smack in the middle, because that's where we're going to spawn anyway. And what we can actually do is we can actually put an island in some of the other grids just around it. So we've got some things to look at. I'm not even going to create a home server in this particular case. because it's going to force us into B8 anyway. Although I could actually make this one the home region, right? Home, it is 1,6. Done. Save. We make that island the zero instance. So in theory, you should actually spawn into B7, but it doesn't actually happen. Right, single player. Once again, blow away the data. Launch into the game, and even though I set my home region to B7, this will force me into B8, which is the current bug in the single player world, which is why you need to have a minimum of 8 grids down. You must include region B8. It's just really weird. I put an island there this time, so I think I might spawn in the water just with how I placed it just outside the island, but we'll find out how good my placement was this time. Ooh, tubby guy. Hey, I actually spawned nicely then. Alright, so we have a look at that. You can actually see I spawned in B8. I actually managed to place the island right in the right spot. So instead of B7 where I set my home region, it's actually put me into B8. But you'll notice that the map is actually working. Alright, so I've actually got my fog of war. And yeah, we can just fly. Smoomoo 10. Come on. That way, I think. Double check. Yeah, that looks about right. Just to show that the map is actually, the fog of war is working. We'll zoom over to the next grid. And there's my other island that I placed on this grid. All right. Slide that back down, and that pretty much does it, right? I haven't investigated all the bugs that potentially are in here. I think there's some other stuff hard-coded. You can see the way I exported, it's actually got the grid names and ports and stuff, but they're fairly irrelevant to this example. I should be able to give FOW, which gives you the fog of war. You have a bit of a lag for a moment while it sorts all that out, and there we basically have an 8x8. So yeah, for those people who want to make custom single-player maps, you must include B8. If you don't, you won't be able to get the map to work. You'll actually spawn in the center of whatever you create, and you won't have a fog of war that even works. None of your islands will be there, etc., etc., etc. The only thing I haven't really tested out is, in the older maps, the Kraken was in the center, so it would have been F6, and whether the power stones work, but I'll be testing that out when I get onto the next part in the series, which will be trying to add in power stone islands and stuff like that, so that you can actually have them in your own private servers. Anyway, for the sake of the video, thanks for watching in, and catch you in the next one.